It was predicted in 2011 that by 2020, customers will manage 85% of their relationships with businesses without interacting with a human. Well, here we are this year with chatbot technology spread across hundreds of channels and picked as the number one way to automate your communications. Let's dig into why chatbots are up there with the greats of modern marketing. Hey guys, it's Geordie here from Neighbourhood, where we help brands find, sell, and keep their people. Chatbots are the perfect way to improve all customer interactions and increase the number of potential business opportunities. 47% of digitally mature organizations say they have a defined artificial intelligence strategy to improve user experience. Are you one of them? If the answer is no, then listen in to find out the five simple steps to implementing a successful chatbot strategy. Step one. Gather information about your potential customers. To kick things off, you should start by gathering information. Find out who your customers are, what they want, which words they use to get their idea across, and get familiar with the customer experience in its full capacity. Many businesses already have data on their customers from different channels. They understand and define customer intents with the help of customer journey maps. Customer journey maps start with awareness and end with the final purchase, followed by brand loyalty. Analyzing different checkpoints during this customer journey will give you insight into what served as a pain point for the customer. This information helps us understand our customers better and in turn creates helpful conversations as part of that chatbot. Step number two, decide what the bot is going to do to meet your customers' expectations. After we've got the customer's expectations down pat, we move on to planning and deciding how a chatbot is going to satisfy the needs of our potential customers. There are six ways a chatbot can meet customer expectations. One, narrow scope. The key here is to not spread ourselves too thin. Answering technical questions is difficult in comparison to answering simple questions. So to ensure our bot provides correct answers and to ensure an effective conversation flow is maintained to allow users to have a positive experience, we keep the scope as narrow as possible. Will we be doing less? Sure, but it's a matter of quality over quantity. And we know we can always widen our scope or purpose in the future when we have a better understanding of customer behaviors. Two, consistent responses. We want our chatbot to have a personality that doesn't sound fake and aligns with our brand's tone of voice. After all, the whole point of it all is to create a real life experience for customers that feels as close to a normal human interaction as possible. Number three is 24/7 availability. Customers are impatient and don't like waiting around for hours to receive a response from human mediated customer service. Chatbots never grow tired of answering user questions straight away. Four, identifying the intent. Chatbots should break down the customer's question and bring up appropriate responses from the database. Five, streamline the experience. The conversation should be seamless and delight customers every step of the way. And six, multiple languages. International clients find it easy to communicate with a bot that understands their native language. Let's go on to step three. Select a platform and build your bot. Once we define our target audience and chatbot objectives to meet the customer expectations, the next logical step is to build a bot using the questions of the customer's responses, network alerts, and APIs. Which platform should you use for building and managing your chatbot? Well, if you're a HubSpot user, you're sorted. But if not, all good. There are plenty of chatbot development companies out there, but our favorite is the AU automation platform. AU is user-friendly and brings you the best results in a matter of minutes. Other chatbot solution providers include Tars, ManyChat, Bot Society, Landbot, and Chatfuel. Step four, check if the chatbot works and improve it further. Our bot learning should not come at the expense of real customers looking for answers. It's best to test bot metrics with staff members and select users before putting it out there for the world to see. Running it by them first will help the chatbot learn to decode new phrases and link them to predefined intents. It'll also discover aspects that hinder user experience, like loopholes, bugs, and new intents that were missing before. Is this enough for officially launching the chatbot? Well, not quite. Who's going to help the staff learn and adapt to new technology and get to grips with new features? They also need to understand how to work with the chatbot tool and to identify their new responsibilities. For this, consider testing by a broad customer base for a short period of time. If you enjoy this video, be sure to subscribe and leave a like. And if you're on YouTube, make sure you hit that bell so you can stay up to date on all our latest videos delivered every week to your inbox. Step number five, launch your chatbot and monitor its activity. Now that we're through with the building, learning, and testing of our chatbot, it's time to finally launch it in the market. Channels you can launch your chatbot on include the client website, Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp, Slack, Telegram, to name a few. Once again, our work is not done here. After launching the new service, we must monitor the activity of the chatbot in terms of its performance, while being bombarded with hundreds and thousands of intense, demanding quick and valuable responses. Metrics such as average handle time and mean time to resolve just won't cut it for a multifaceted channel that juggles multiple queries simultaneously. You should be constantly monitoring the completion rate, bounce rate, and reuse rate. Monitoring these relevant metrics helps us gather more data that you can feed into the chatbot's learning process for future references. There you have it. Now that we've gone through the five steps of implementing an effective chatbot strategy, you should have a good idea of how you can get the ball rolling to build your additional customer service offering. If you found this video helpful, then feel free to share it with someone you know that needs a hand with chatbots. You can also subscribe to our blog where you'll find a bunch more tools, tips, and templates to help you find, sell, and keep your people. just like Neighborhood does. So that's it from me. Happy marketing. We'll be right back.